Okay, good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining me today. Happy Monday. I hope everyone had a good trading day. Let's talk about what happened today in the market. So let's go over our watch list. Let's see what happened with the SPYs. Wow, look at the SPY. This is the stock's trend over the past 1 year. This is phenomenal. This is how wealth is made. I mean, if you have a lot of money in the market over the past year, you had no choice but to make money because the market has gone straight up. This is the lows of COVID lows, which was March 23rd is when the market bounced this week. It was a low of 218, and it came all the way up to a high this past week of 447. That's probably unheard of. Maybe it's happened sometime. I've just never heard of it happening so quickly. So I hope everyone is sitting on a big fat stack of cash. Okay, so today we're talking about technical analysis. Let's go with the slides. So what is technical analysis? It's the art of reading price movement over time. Okay. So if we were just looking at the chart, x-axis being the horizontal axis, or the x-axis being the time, the y-axis or the vertical axis being the price. Okay. So it's the art of reading price movement over time. It's used to predict what is likely to happen, and it can be used for all type of markets. Okay. So let's talk about something called Dow theory. Okay, so what is Dow theory? Dow theory means that there are three market movements or trends. So the movements that a market makes is also called a trend. You have a main trend, which is the long-term trend. You have a medium trend, and you have a short-term trend, okay? So a main trend or the long-term trend is the overall trend. You usually look about 1 to 2 years for it to have a main trend. You just want it to be greater than 9 months. So that's why I really want you guys to look at the 1 year, 1 day chart. So you can look at the overall long-term trend, okay? An intermediate trend or a medium trend is consisting of about 1 month to 9 months. So you can get a full picture when you look at the 3 month to 6 month chart. Okay. That will tell you what the medium trend is. And then a short term trend is usually less than a month. Okay. So on this graph, on this illustration here, the main trend we have in green, that's this will be your 1 year to 2 year trend. Your medium would be the orange lines. That's about 3 to 9 months. And then the short-term trend that dictated that in blue, that's usually going to be 1 month. So I had you guys do a homework assignment of recognizing trends and recognizing support and resistance, right? So what is support and resistance? Support and resistance are just prices that buyers and sellers like the stock or the ETF to stay above or below. Okay, so let's pull up that slide. Okay, so you have price support and resistance. Okay, so you have a horizontal ceiling, also known as resistance, or horizontal floor, also known as support. And that those are basically price points. Any 2 points you can draw a line through, that will tell you what that resistance price is or what that support price is. For trend support and resistance, you draw diagonal ceiling and diagonal floor. So let's look at this chart, okay? So this is a chart of the SPY. If I look at the overall 1 year trend, we see that this is obviously an up trend. I mean, it's very, very bullish. How do we know what an uptrend is? It's making higher highs and higher lows. What is the support? Support is basically the price that buyers don't want the price to go below. Okay, so like sellers can sell it. Let me annotate. Sellers can sell it down. Like for an example, this is a clear support. Sellers can sell it down, and then it caught this level right here. It also caught this same level right about here. And this is not exact science. You just want it to be as horizontal as possible. So this right here, because these yellow lines are below where the price action is, we can draw a price level. And this price level will be called support. Support because it's below. The sellers tried to bring it down. The buyer said, no. I'm gonna buy it right back up. That support is around $370. Okay. So what is resistance? Resistance is the ceiling. It's the line that you could draw above the price. It's the price that sellers don't want the price to go above. So right around here, this same area, we have from in February. We had the buyers buy it up. The bulls were in charge here. And then all of a sudden, right around 394, and just pro tip, the investors, traders like round numbers. So like 50, 55, 60, 65. So whenever you have those round numbers, just look to see levels of support and resistance at those levels. So right here, for an example, this level was around 390, around 394. Okay. So this is a level that the buyers bought it up to, and the sellers said no, and they pushed it back down. So this is significant as resistance. Okay. And if you see here, when March came, the buyers brought it back up to this 394, tried to go above it, went above it for two trading days, and then brought it back down. The bulls are able to take control again right around the end of the month, March 31st. And then now this level is going to be support, but it's far gone support because right now the SPY's closed today at approximately 446.97. So a pretty bullish trend. I mean, this is a very significant bullish trend over the past 5 months. Okay, so let's go back to the slides. So we want to draw horizontal levels of support and resistance, and we can use that price drawing tool on thinkorswim. But we also want to know what the trend is because stocks move high, up, down, up, down, like a stair step. So then we can draw diagonal ceilings and diagonal floors using to signify trend, okay? Which also acts as support and resistance. So right here, we see that this white line here, this is support. Well, excuse me, this is resistance over here. So once it came here, it's resistance. It stopped, came back down, and then came back up and broke resistance here. Then it then so now it's so once this the stock got above this level, it's support, this level support now. It was acting as resistance, then now it's support because the price is above it. Okay, and you could see that because it came right back down to this support, it couldn't go through and bounced right back up. Okay, so this is a good way to study what support and resistance looks like, and for you guys to practice drawing lines at different price levels that it has bounced at over and over again. Okay, so that would be support and resistance for price. So support and resistance for trend, similar, but it's not horizontal vertical. Now it is diagonal. Okay, so let's go back to the SPY so we can draw that. And we want to draw it as a channel. So I'm just going to get rid of these price levels. Let's draw it as a channel. So how do we draw a channel? We draw a channel where it can intersect as many points as possible. So let's say if I were to draw a channel, I could draw it, let's go 6 months. I would want to start from the close. I like to draw my channels from the close to the open, meaning the bodies of the candles. I don't use the wicks, which will be the low and the highs. If you want to use the wicks, just make sure you're consistent. If you're going to use the lows of the wicks on the bottom side, use the high of the wicks on the top side. I'm going to use the body. So I start with mine. So let's go to channel, and then you draw as intersecting as many bars as possible. So that'll be for the downside. For the upside, it would look something like this. So this is how I would draw a channel on my graph. So this will be 6 months. If you want to get a little bit more tighter, you could get tighter. You would probably need to change your time frame. So you could change this to a 3 month, 1 day, and then get even tighter. However, some of your days are going to go below your trend. Okay, so for an example, you could get as tight as this, and as tight as this. If you want to be more exact, I just don't like the way this looks. I don't want to give myself such a small trading price window. That's why I like the way I drew it the first time, using the 6 month, 1 day. And then this is a pretty steep channel. And this is what the SPYs have been doing the past 6 months, okay? So if you were to try to guess what trend that the SPYs are moving in right now, you would say bullish. It's making higher highs, higher lows. We haven't had a pullback in quite some time. When I say pullback, they usually use a 10% drawdown as a pullback. We really haven't had that in quite some time. So the SPYs are definitely due, but that doesn't mean you don't invest or you don't trade. You want to get in because the market has been definitely, definitely bullish for quite some time. Okay. Okay. So make sure you guys can recognize the trend, and let's go over the homework. So trend, uptrend, higher highs, higher lows, downtrend, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, sideways, no definite pattern. Okay. So let's go over the homework. Okay. So this is the homework, trend recognition and support resistance worksheet. So let's look at the stock symbol IWM. Okay. So the stock symbol IWM, let's pull that up so we can see what the overall trend is. Okay, so this is going back 6 month, 1 day. I'm going to get rid of all of these price levels off of the screen. Okay, so what did we say a long-term trend was? We said that's greater than 9 months. So let's first pull up the 1 year, 1 day. Okay, 1 year, 1 day, IWM, I would say that this is bullish. It's a bullish trend. If you look at the beginning, it started like right around 154. It came down to 142, and then it went all the way up to 234. So the first, from August 2020 till about March, it was very bullish. And then around March, we kind of started moseying sideways. So overall trend, I would say bullish. However, intermediate trend, I would say sideways. What's an intermediate trend? Let's look at our 6 month, 1 day chart. Okay. So this is what happened the 6 months. So this is a 6 month time frame. Every candle's 1 day. So if you look at what happened here, February 16th, IWM closed at around, 225. And then it had a low with this long wick. I don't really like the wicks. I like the bodies of the candle. So I'm good. This is what I see. I see a price level, meaning support, at around $212. And I see resistance. I see a few resistance levels that you can draw. I see one at around $233. And I also see strong resistance at around $220. Let's see. I would say $225. Okay, 225, and then I would also draw some support right around here. Okay, so let's see what I did. So today, the IWM was a down day. The reason why I put a price level around 217 was because of the, and this is a lot of chatter, but it still stayed within a price level, within price range. So right here, we had a low at 8.3 on this day. Then right here, it couldn't close below, on 7.27, it couldn't close below 217. It broke this 217 on this day. However, this 217 has shown that it's either bouncing to the upside or bouncing to the downside off of this level. So usually when it came down, it bounced to the upside off of 217. That's why I drew that level of support there. I also drew it at 212 because we saw it stopped here on March 24th, also on 512, also on 720. So that level, these levels are significant. Okay, so the closest level, so basically for the homework, the closest level of support from today's candle would be around 217 to between 215 217 level. Okay, the closest level of resistance will be around 225. Okay, so if I wanted to put a trade on, a bullish trade, let's say like a bull put spread, I wouldn't want to put anything above 215. Okay, so what you could do is you could right click, go to edit properties and change this value to 215. I wouldn't want to put my bull put anywhere above 215. Why? Because that's a strong level of support. And if I would put a bear call on, I would not want to put my bear call anywhere below 223. It's trading it. So I drew this line around 225. So let's just say we have 215 to 225. Okay. So that's why it's really important to draw support and resistance lines. So that will determine where you want to construct your credit spreads. If you're able to place your credit spread, your bull put below support and your bear call above resistance, it increases the probabilities of your trade being successful. Why? Because we see that's a level, the 215 is a level that buyers really don't want it to go below. You see it went below here on one day and the buyers bought it up. It went below here one day on 512, the buyers bought it right back up. It went below that level on 324, the buyers bought it right back up. It went below this level here on 34, the buyers bought it back up. So it seems that whenever the IWM gets below the price of 215, the buyers tend to buy it back up. That's why it is considered strong support level, okay? And the reason why I drew both of these lines as resistance is because the 225 and also this 233 level, that's where the sellers have not been wanting it to stay above that much. We had made a high 234 on 315 and it hasn't seen that high yet. Okay, the sellers sold it right back down. And then it got to this level that we drew 225, but I would say that the IWM is going to have a hard time getting above this 233 level in the near future, because this is what this is what the support and resistance levels are telling us. Okay, let's go to another one. SMH. Okay, this is a semiconductor ETF. So let's look at the long-term trend. So let's look at a year. Long-term, to me, this looks bullish. We have a low of around 163 in September, and then we have a high of 271 in August. I mean, this is bullish, okay? For an intermediate trend, which look at the 6-month, 1-day, this is still bullish. It did have a high of 257 and sold down. And then the buyers bought it back up, and then a seller sold it down. But the majority of the time from May to around August, it's made higher highs and higher lows, okay? So I would say even the intermediate trend is bullish. Let's look at the short-term trend of a month. So a month, this is bullish as well. We have higher highs, higher lows. If the SMH breaks this level of 257, then we might have a downtrending stock or even a sideways moving stock, but we would need more data than what we currently have. Let's draw support and resistance levels. So I like to go about a year out. So had a high of 271. Every time a stock or ETF makes a new high, you automatically would put, and comes back down, you automatically will put that price level as resistance. Okay, because that's the price that the sellers sold it down to. Okay, so resistance right here is going to be 271 on the SMH. Where's support? Support is going to be the level that the level that the buyers do not want it to go below. Look at that. That level is around 257. I already have it marked on here, which was previous resistance. It was previous strong resistance here on February 16th. Here on, let me draw it for you. Okay. Here on this date. Here on this date. Here on this date, here, these days here. So this old resistance is now support. So if you wanted to put a bull put on, you could definitely put one on under to the level of 257, okay? I would do something like this. Okay, I would put my bull put here. I would sell this put and then buy this put. However, this is a good segue to talk about the simple moving averages. Okay, so what are the simple moving averages? Okay. So when a trend is not so obvious, we can confirm the trend with technical indicators like the simple moving averages or the SMA. It's a formula that smooths the day-to-day fluctuations of a stock price. The day-to-day, let's say you have the 6-month, 1-day. If you have a simple moving average 20, that smooths, that averages the past 20 days and creates a line. Let's say you have a 1-day, 1-minute chart and you have the simple moving 20 that averages the last 20 minutes into a line, okay? So it takes a certain number of days or time frame depending on what chart you're looking at and creates the average of the closing prices. That's another reason why when I draw my trend lines, I like to use the bodies of the candles, because that's what the simple moving averages use, the closing prices. Opening and closing prices are really common when you're trying to determine the trend, not the wicks, not the highs and the lows, because those don't tell you as much data. The opening and closing prices really gives you a lot of data on what the day-to-day, where the money flow is going, okay? A trend is considered to be up as long as the price is above the moving average line and the line is rising. A combination of moving averages tells the strength of a trend. A strong uptrend, meaning the shorter moving average is above the longer. Okay, so I like to use the simple moving 9, 20, 50, 100, and the 200. So let's construct them on the chart now, okay? So let me get rid of these. I'll leave that one on there so we can see if any of our simple moving averages falls on that. Okay, so this is how you construct it on your Thinkorswim. You go to your edit studies page and then you just search simple moving average, okay? Add. I'm going to add 5 of them, okay? So I'm gonna do this 5 times. Add, 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 okay? Oops. So I like my 9, I like my simple moving 9 to be white, okay? I like my simple moving 20 to be turquoise. So I'm gonna change the length to 20. So now it's telling me, now I'm telling the study how to calculate the simple moving average on my chart. So you have the price, the closing price, the length is 20, and then I changed it to turquoise, okay? I like my 100, my 50, my simple moving 50 to be navy blue. So that's like right here. You can get super creative and super fancy with Thinkorswim. These are all the colors that you can use. I just clicked on that turquoise blue, and that's just basically the training that I had. You could do whatever color you want. Okay. I like my 100 to be orange. So I'm gonna change the length to 100 and then change it to orange. And then I like my 200 to be magenta, okay? Then you click on apply and then you hit okay. So I don't always have all 5 of these simple moving averages on my chart at the same times, because sometimes it can get kind of noisy. If I'm looking to do a short-term trend, a short-term trade, I might just look at the simple moving 9, right? Because that's a shorter time, they're taking into the last nine trading days to see what happened. I always have the 20 and the 50 up. I don't always have the orange, the 100 up, and I always have the 200 moving average up, okay? So I'm going to take off the orange and the white, and I'll show you how I do that. So the orange will be the 100. So if you don't want it to be visible, you just click on the gear and just click on check show study. Okay. So that just took off the orange, and then do the same for the 9. Apply. So now you just have the turquoise, which is the 20, the blue, which is the 50, and the magenta, which is the 200. And if you want them back on, you just go onto the study and then click them, the gear, and they'll come right back on, okay? All right. Now, if you want to do it as a, as a short code too, where you just have it under style, and then show study. If I unclick all of them, then they all go away. If I click it, then the ones that I clicked in that study, in the study tab will show. Okay? Okay. So where we drew, so if the price is above the shorter moving average, it's considered up, right? It's considered an uptrend. If it's below the simple moving average, then it's considered a downtrend, depending on what is going on, which SMA we're going to be using. So let's look at another stock, okay? Let's look at BABA. So what is the overall trend of BABA? If you said downtrend, ding, 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 you are 100% correct. How do we know that? We know, let me get this off so I can, let's see. We know that Baba, let's see, I want to fit, I'm going to take these orders off. Fit orders. Okay. These are my actual trades. So let's see. Show trades. Okay, so we know that Baba is downtrending. Why? Baba is making lower highs and lower lows. Okay. It made a high here on around in November. And then it came down here. High, low, lower high, lower low. Put that lower low here. I'll take that one off. So then it start. Then it decided. So after it made this downtrend here, and this is over the past This is over the past year. It started to go back up. So this whole time, once it broke through below the 20, that means the past 20 days, it's on a downtrend. Okay. Then it broke that down here. So the past 50 days, it's been below this, that price level. Okay. So on November 10th, it broke below the 50 moving, the simple moving day 50. So that means that this, the last 50 days, Baba has been below that, the 50 moving average. Okay. The past 50 days has been below this price. And then it got down below the 200 day average on December 24th. Okay. Let's see. Oops. Okay. Once a stock gets below the simple 200, it's considered downtrending over the long term, okay? Because the simple 200 is an average of the past 200 days. So it takes the average of the past 200 days, and Baba right here, that price was below the price for the last 200 days. It went back above it, but then it came back below it on February 22nd, and it has not been below, it has not been above the simple moving 200 since. So let's continue to draw the trend of Baba. So we had a higher here, but then we had a lower low, lower high from here, lower low. This actually is a higher high, but then it made a higher low. It made a lower high. So this made a, this was a higher high and this was a lower high. Then it made a lower low, lower high, lower low. It made a higher high here and it broke the simple moving 20 and 50. So if you could have definitely thought that Baba was going to get into a bullish trade and possibly do something like this. But then it didn't. On this day here, the trend changed again on June 30th. And then it continued the downtrend that it's been going. So because Baba, and it's at support right now, 182. So because Baba is on a down, is a downtrending stock, both the long term, the intermediate term, and the short term, we know this because we see it, the different time frames, both for the 1 year, if we look at the 6 month, it's downtrending. If we look at the 1 month, see, look at 30 days, downtrending. And it's under your 20, your 50, and your 200 moving day average. You do not want to put a bullish trade on Baba. Okay. I know if you look at the fundamentals, you could say, oh, they're great. They're like the Amazon of China. But until you see it break the trend and get like all the news that's been on the China stocks, until you see that kind of go away, I would stay away from trading anything bullish on BABA. Okay. So BABA's definitely downtrending. Okay. Okay. So the last level of resistance, I would say right around here. I would say around 200 was the last resistance. So right now BABA's at support. If BABA breaks support here, the next level you would have to increase your time frame. You can go to 3 years. The next level of support for BABA would be I would say the 174 level. Okay. Okay, let's do another one. Okay, so we did the IWM. Let's do Netflix. Netflix. So Netflix, let's look at the long term, medium term, and short term trend of Netflix. So Netflix, let's look 1 year, 1 day. I mean, 1 year, 1 day, Netflix to me is moving sideways. It looks like it's moving sideways. Literally a year ago, Netflix closed at 482.35, and right now it's trading at 517. It closed at 517. I mean, that's what is that? That's a $40 move from a year ago. Netflix is a mover. I mean, Netflix can move $20 in a day. So for it to move $40 in a year, that's pretty sideways, okay? So let's look at the intermediate trend. So we look at the 6 month, 1 day. This looks kind of noisy. I mean, to me, this looks sideways. I would draw resistance. I would go to the 1 year, 1 day. I would draw my resistance levels here. I would draw my resistance levels definitely here. I would draw my support here. And I would draw my support here. Okay, so this 510 level, I will consider that support right now. And the closest level of resistance, I would say, well, the closest level, I would say even tighter than this 554, I would say right here. Because look at it, tried to get above 5, like 520, 523 on 728. The sellers push it down. They try to do it again. 86, the sellers pushed it down. Okay. Which was also where it closed at here on 331. So I would say about 523. So it's running kind of like a tight range right now. Honestly, you could totally do an iron butterfly on this. I'll show you guys what that is. It's just selling a put and a call at the same strike and buying the wings out. Or you could do a bull put here underneath this level and a bear call up here. I wouldn't want to do a bear call necessarily right now on Netflix just because it's making this shape of a W, which looks like this. So if it breaks that 523 level, it could go up to 555 or even right here, 536. Okay. So that's the only thing, that's the only reason why I wouldn't put a bear call on Netflix, because it bounced off of support, came up, bounced off of support, came up, bounced off of support, came up. It could definitely come back down. However, if it breaks that 523, it can go to 536 or 554. So I'm okay with trading a bull put on this. I'm not okay with trading I'm not comfortable with trading a bear call. Okay. Okay. Okay, the next one, let's look at UNH. Okay, so this is, let's see, 1 year, 1 day, UNH is bullish. I mean, it was low at 321 a year ago. Today it closed at 417, okay? Shorter term, I would 6 month, 1 day, I would say bullish. Yep, 6 month, 1 day, because closed around 320, got to 417 as well, okay? You see that? And then I would say for a 1 month, 1 day, I would say sideways. I mean, it's just completely sideways over the past month. It stayed within the support of around 405 with resistance at around 422. Okay, so let's look at a bigger time frame. Yeah, so around 405 to 422. This 415 was broken today, but that was resistance previously. If you see here, couldn't get above it there, couldn't get above it there, but today it broke that resistance. I would say it's going to come up to 422 and then come back down. If it breaks 422, well, then you're off to the races. Okay. Okay. So we went over the simple moving averages. We went over the how to identify support and resistance. I want us to go over, let's see, making sure we're comfortable with drawing channels, okay? So we saw the SPYs. Today was a SPY. Very bullish. We looked at the IWM. Moving sideways. Let's look at the Qs. The Qs were pretty, the Qs have been bullish. Yeah, this is 6 month, 1 day. So this is a bullish trend. This has been bullish. The DIA, which is the Dow Jones, that's bullish as well. How do we know that? The Dow Jones is making higher lows and higher highs. Okay. Let's see. Here, here, then we had a lower low, and then it was moving sideways for about, since April, it was, the Dow was moving sideways, and then it's kind of breaking out, because it broke this level of resistance here, which was the previous high. Once it broke this level on this day was August 10th, I would think the Dow Jones is going to keep going up. Of course, anything can happen. Right now we're dealing with, you know, the Afghanistan, we're dealing with the Delta variant, we're dealing with a lot of potential market moving events, but looks like the market is kind of shaking all that off. shaking it off, because it hasn't really budged from the underlying trend. I mean, wars and you know, pandemics normally would move a market. However, in the past current events, that it hasn't done much to the market. The market has been proven to be resilient. Okay. It might be because of the amount of liquidity that's in the market right now. It might be because of just the fact that, you know, companies are beating earnings. I mean, every quarter you have the companies, there haven't been many companies that have not been beating earnings. So there's no investors are thinking there's no reason not to keep investing. Okay, so that's basically the flow of the money. Okay, so also as far as the SPY, I want to show you guys the VIX. So what is the VIX? The VIX is also known as the fear indicator, as the market volatility index. It's a basically tells you how many people are buying puts right now. What are puts? Puts are something that you want to buy if you think the market goes down, right? When you're long puts. If you're long puts, you think the market's going to go down, you make money on the stock or the ETF going down. So there's a way to track these puts. They're called by the VIX, the volatility index. So today when the market opened down, the VIX spiked up. Let's look at the 1 day, 1 minute. The VIX spiked up all the way to 17. It got from 15 to 17. So that's a pretty big move. And then it sold right back off. So if you're thinking the volatility, when do we like to put on selling strategies? When the volatility is higher, okay? So right, if you had a crystal ball, right when the market opened up today and the VIX spiked, this is the time you want to put your bull puts on in the market. So, 'cause look what happened. Let's look at the SPX. The SPX opened, as soon as the market opened, it opened down. It got as low as 44.37 and then closed at 44.80. That's almost a $50 move in a day. So if you saw the VIX spiking, so look at this. The SPX, as soon as it opened up today, opened down as a low around 10:30. 10:30, you have this double bottom, which you know is a bullish sign. So once you had this double bottom here, that is a bullish sign. It's a bullish reversal. You could have put your bull puts on down here. So let's look at the 6 month, 1 day, and which was confirmed from the VIX. The VIX opened, it spiked up. Let's see, right around. Let's see, this would be 10 o'clock here. So 10 o'clock, look at that. The VIX had a double top. So once you had this double top on the VIX, it's a sign that the VIX is going to come back down, okay? And it was confirmed from a double bottom from the SPX, right? So once you got that double bottom on the SPX, it's a sign that's going to continue going up. Now, are these certain? No, nothing is certain. But in this particular case, it was confirmed, the SPX going up was confirmed by the chart, right? And also the VIX. So those two right there of confirmation of the VIX spiking, making a double top coming back down, the SPX plummeting, making a double bottom and then coming back up. These are signs that'll tell you if you're day trading or watching the chart closely, you want to put on a bull put expiring in September, like I did. Let me show you what that looks like. So you look at something like Amazon. You saw Amazon selling off. It got down to a low of 3,3210. It could not break below the simple moving 200. This simple moving 200 has shown to be strong support for Amazon since, well, since for a long time. I mean, even if you go back, even in February, it came down for a few trading days, but then they found the buyers found their way back above the simple moving 200. So Amazon got low as 3210. You could have got, and because the VIX is high, the volatility is high, that means you're getting better premium. You could have put on a bull put all the way down here on Amazon. Probably could have got lower. And why is that significant? Because it allows you to get under this 200, under this support. You could have even, let's see, this is like support here, 3165. So I would say 3165, or closed here, closed here. 3165, I would consider that support. I would want to get my book, put my pull put under here. Now that Amazon's trading at 3298, it's going to be hard for me to get paid if I put my bull put by selling the 3150. I mean, I'm not going to get peanuts on that. But if I was watching the chart and saw this long wick come down here, monitored the VIX, monitored the SPX, which is 500 in the index that monitors 500 stocks, I could have gotten very far from price. I could have gotten far from price on Facebook. Look at that. Could have put my bull put probably even underneath this 50, which is strong support, and it's below my diagonal channel that I drew. Then Microsoft, same. That long, whenever you have long wicks like that, and you're watching the chart, you want to see if it's going to make some type of technical signal to make you get in. The technical signal, which was the double bottom on this SPX, the technical signal, which was the double top on the VIX. Let's see what else about. Okay, let's see. If I look at Boeing. Boeing really didn't really they didn't really buy Boeing back up. So those are ways that you can get confirmation on your trades. Okay, let's see what else went down. The XLY. Yep, the XLY is a consumer discretionary. I put a bull put on this today. Once I saw that this sold down to the 50, I wanted to get way below that. I think I got paid right here at the 175. It's supposed to be straight. And then I'm sure I bought the 170 or 171 down here. So this is a pretty safe trade. I mean, if you look, it's been above 175 for the past. It hasn't gotten below, it's got below 175 on July 19th, but it hasn't seen below 175 since June 23rd. So if you can get below where it's been trading at for the past 2 months, my friends, that's a pretty good trade. It increases the probabilities of your trade being successful because you're getting below several levels of support. Okay? All righty. So that's our time. So we talked about the simple moving day averages. We talked about when to look at the VIX and compare that with the SPX. We talked about support and resistance and how to draw our trend lines and also our simple moving day averages on our chart. Okay, let me know if you have any questions. Shoot me an email and join us tomorrow as we have our trade room. Okay, let's get paid.